G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today it's time for another vlog, mailbag, that kind of thing. You know, the regular thing we've been doing. I've got a nice big stack of mail here, and I don't know, it was about Valentine's Day. I was hoping to get some Valentine's Day letters. I don't think I got any Valentine's Day stuff. Y'all don't love me. I don't know, but I got a big stack of stuff, including some international stuff, so it's really interesting. I had to sign for some of it because it was like special delivery signed for tracking number and all that other good stuff. So, see about this first letter. This letter is from Easton. If you're around Easton, not Eastern as in East and West, Easton. It says, "Dear Mr. Paladin, how are you today?" Well, I'm doing fine today. I'm having me a good day. You know, there was a big Team Fortress 2 update. I'll have to talk about that real soon. "I wanted to thank you for helping me get better at TF2. Your spy videos helped me prevent from getting backstabbed." Well, that's nice. I like it when they help classes other than the spy because, you know, everybody can be helped out with a whole bunch of stuff. "I've decided that since I love Pokemon and Team Fortress 2, I'll pair up my Pokemon team with my favorite TF2 YouTubers for each class. Since your main is Spy, you'd be paired with my team Spy." Ooh. Sire, who is an Espeon. Okay, I know what an Espeon is. See, I'm a cool dad. I kind of know what Pokemon type stuff is. That's one of the... That evolution has a whole bunch. It has like a fire type. You've got Vapion as well. Yeah. "I've already decided to make Muzilk be paired with my soldier Lucario, and a Ray-7 should be paired with Mimi, my medic Blissey." Yeah, I know what a Blissey is. "One other pairing I've done with my character, who is an engineer with Uncle Dane. If you could suggest people for the other classes, I'd be grateful." Well, come on. You need flame type in here. There's a whole bunch of pyros out there that are practically screaming for a Pokemon flame type. Come on. Guys, put down below some flame type Pokemon and some other pyro mains that you'd like to see paired up in this Pokemon team, and I'm sure we'll be able to get it done. And remember, never judge a book by its cover. Its pages might surprise you, and those pages might help you someday. Thank you." Absolutely. Good advice there. I mean, I don't know how many books you guys have read, you know. I tend to look for science fiction type books. I've read a lot of Tolkien, and I've read a lot of sci-fi stuff. I like reading my Warhammer 40K stuff. I've read a few omnibuses. And, you know, that's the type of stuff that I like when I read. But it's really hard to tell with the sci-fi stuff which books are good just by their cover, because you could have a really, really good artist doing the cover on the book, but the actual content of the book is epically gripping. I think one of the books that I really liked, and I wasn't sure about the art, was The Soul Drinker's Omnibus, okay? Because, I don't know, when it comes to Warhammer 40K stuff, The Soul Drinkers didn't really take my interest, but as I read more into the Omnibus forum, it became more interesting. So, yeah, there's all sorts of stuff. Never judge someone by their looks. I mean, people can insult you for your looks all the time. They can insult you for the hats you wear in Team Fortress 2, but that doesn't make a lick of difference, so don't worry about it. Next is from Painter. Not a painter, from the suburb of Painter. I'm just giving the suburbs, just so people can kind of say, "Ooh, is it my one? I don't know if it's my one or not." I'm not going to give the street name because, you know, I don't want anyone creeping. Let's see, you got... "Hello, Mr. Paladin. Hopefully you've received this letter. If so, I want to say I love your videos." Well, that's kind of weird, because if I didn't get the letter, then how would I have known? I don't know. I've got the letter. "If so, I want to say I love your video. You have inspired me to be spy main." Cool. "I don't have much stuff for the spy." Don't worry, we just got over that. I mean, hats don't mean anything. In fact, sometimes I strip off my hats so people think less about me when I'm playing spy and more about themselves. They might pass me off as being a bad spy or something like that. "I only have a Lutron J right now, Diamondback, and Ambassador. I should tell you a bit about me. My name is Max." Hey, Max. I'm not going to give out your Steam name just in case your Steam account gets slammed, okay? I have some questions if you don't mind. Don't mind at all. Are you a Christian? Yes, I'm a Christian. I was raised Baptist, and I'm still Baptist, and I'm in the South USA. Lots of Baptist stuff around here. Okay, he's got an off-cam question, so I'm not going to say that. Tips for a noob like me. Okay, you just... Two things, okay? You've got a learning curve as you learn anything about TF2, okay? One of the first things that happened to me was, like, I got attacked. I shot a spy on... It was, like, on 2-Fort, okay? I just joined TF2. I came in as a sniper because it was something that was familiar, easy to do. Sniping on 2-Fort, no problem. You go up to the battlements, you pew-pew across, and that's sniping, okay? Now, while I was up there, I saw a spy, and I'm thinking, okay, no problem. Shot the spy, was dead. No problem, whatever. Went back to shooting. A few moments later, that same spy killed me, and I'm like, wait a minute, I know I killed that spy. So it confused me, and I'm, you know, the cogs are turning in my head, and I'm thinking, maybe this guy's cheating, because, you know, I didn't have any experience in Team Fortress 2. I had no idea. So shortly after that, I looked at him, and I saw the item, the Dead Ringer, and at that point I'm like, oh, there's so many items that change the way this game runs. So I went across to the wiki, I clickety-click-click to the wiki, and I was like, I need to read up on the items. And I saw about the cow mangler, I saw about the different mediguns. So much stuff was learned that day, okay? And that's all part of the learning curve. The faster you can do that with things like reading the wiki, with watching TF2 videos and stuff like that to see how some of the better players play, that is very good. I mean, I can watch some high-level comp stuff and learn stuff all the time. There's always room to grow, but it's always a curve, okay? The faster you can get yourself up that learning curve, the better, and I highly suggest doing that. What is my favorite mode? I like Payload. Payload kind of forces the gameplay. I kind of like it. It forces the defenders to defend. It forces the attackers to get on the objective, so I kind of like it. Although, my old favorite used to be Capture the Flag before Team Fortress 2. I'm kind of disappointed that Team Fortress 2 has let down Capture the Flag. It's not as good as it used to be. That's all. I love your videos. Turn to the other side for fan art. I like the fan art. You see the fan art I've got up on my board? There's even something I drew right there. That's a picture of, like, a self-portrait that I used to do when I was in school, and I got kind of good at doing him. Let's see. Where's the Paladin? The heavies are jealous of his skills. I like that. Okay, this is just a pencil sketch, and it looks... I'm face-stabbing a scout. Okay, I'll put that up on the board later. I've got to find more room. You see what I'm kind of doing with it? Now, don't be too upset if, like, your picture's been up there a while, and I have to, like, rotate around pictures, but I'm going to be keeping everything. I'll keep it in a folder somewhere or something. I also expect to have more stuff around. I got a lot of blank walls here. I don't know. Gonna make it more TF2 YouTuberish stuff like that. Ooh, where'd all my letters go? My letters vanished. They were there all the time. They were cloaked. One from Tarrytown. Tarrytown. Don't tarry in Tarrytown. Tarry's a funny word. I haven't heard the word tarry in a long time. Tarry not. It's a very proper word. Not too many proper words are used over here in America. Okay, what have we got here? It's folded up. Okay, what do we got? Oh, we got some arts. I'll show the arts in a little bit. We got a good bit of a letter here. G'day, Mr. Paladin. There's a lot I would like to say. G'day, Mr. Paladin. There is a lot I would like to say. First and foremost, and hands down, best spy ever? Well, thank you. I don't think I am. I just think I'm a really good player. I don't think I rank on the best, but, you know, I know my stuff, sure. I have many friends who don't know how to play spy, and I always recommend Mr. Paladin. TF2 is a great game, aside from the trolls and hackers. Yeah, I agree with that. Hate the people who try and disrupt multiplayer games. I mean, why? Darn trolls. Very hedonistic. And honestly, I love it because it's... Ooh. I've got a tongue twister word. It's varietied gameplay. Varietied. That's not a word I've used often. In a Q&A you did some time ago, you mentioned you did D&D, Dungeons and Dragons. In my high school, we have a D&D club. Cool. It's so fun. You use so much imagination. I mean, it's your imagination goes wild. I love getting into a group where the person who's running the game really lets me like go off the rails. I mean, here, if you want to see like D&D, you see my shirt? Woo! I don't get older, I level up. Okay. Like for serious, I like RPGs. They're lots of fun, especially if you can get a group of friends and like totally just play off the rails. Somebody is running a Kenda character and they just come running back to your party and you go, "Oh yeah, there's a crowd following me." And you're like, "Oh, what did you do, Kenda?" You know, it just gets the ball rolling. It's so much fun. Sure, a lot of the games I like to follow set scripts, but I really, really love the ones where the person controlling it can just allow for anything to happen. It was hilarious. Let's see. And I choose a paladin for no reason because you're a paladin. Paladin's a fun class. Let's see. So far, I find the style fairly nice. I can't say I'm the best. It's the only class I've been so far. Oh, there's a lot of classes that are a lot of fun. Like I said, I've also done RPGs in like Vampire the Masquerade, and I loved being a Malkavian, okay? Malkavians are a vampire that are a little bit crazy, okay? And because of their craziness, they get some additional insight into stuff. Oh man, Malkavians are crazy fun. Your casual games are always fun. I've participated in a few. Awesome, and it's always an honor since not many people actually play with well-known YouTubers. Yeah, I try to play as much as possible. I mean, I know the server limit's only 24, and I know when I announce games it gets slammed, but I try and play as much as possible. I've gone by several names in the TF2 universe, including a couple different names. I'm not gonna announce them just because I don't want your account to be slammed. Let's see, over the other side. I was going through the video one day, and I was NG. At the moment, you helped protect a level 3 sentry. This was a while back. It's okay if I don't remember. I don't know. I have so many videos and so much stuff happening. Ooh, excuse me. It was nice to know that you're a great player to have on a team. I like to always be a good teammate, okay? I always like to. I don't mind, you know. People think I'm going after stats and stuff. I don't care. I'll throw myself endlessly at an objective. People will dominate on me because I'm trying to cap the objective. I'm just trying to be a good teammate, okay? If that means throwing myself in front of a crit rocket that's coming at an engineer, whatever. I don't care. You die, you respawn. Means nothing. Your videos and tutorials are a lot of help. I went from a scrub spy to being a better spy. Excellent. I like the term scrub spy. I wouldn't see the scrub. Ooh, scrub. The Lenny face scrub I got last time. I've also learned to sharpen my senses when hearing decloaks. Yeah, definitely have your audio up. I know some people modify their sound files. I don't like that, but yeah, once you know a spy's around, keep an ear out. P.S. The fan art took me a while to draw. I consider it myself artistically challenged, but my peers tell me otherwise. Have a great day. Okay, I don't mind that. Let's see. You've got blood on my suit. Okay, this is the artwork here. It is a dimensionally correct. I like how the stance is. I like the little bit of shading you got for like the shoulders and stuff like that. That's attention to detail. I like that. I like stuff like that. It shows you're trying to get proportions right and you're getting shading right. I like. I'll pin it up on my board soon. Put my letter into storage. Save my letters. Always save your letters and throw away your old receipts. That's what I say. That was the old saying, you keep your love letters and you throw away your receipts. These aren't exactly love letters, but they are kind letters where people are being kind and generous to me. So I like to keep things like that close. Keep your friends close indeed, and keep your enemies' backs in front of you. Okay, we've got some art on the back of this one too. Okay, this is a quick one. Thanks, Mr. Pia. I learned a lot from you, and I became more aware of how the game works. And it depended more on skill than luck. Then again, never true luck. Never trade luck for skill. Are you kidding me? I will trade luck for skill any day of the week. If I could be 100% lucky, doesn't matter how much skill you have. I'll take luck over skill. Now, that's a weird... It's a weird concept, but yeah. P.S. Excuse the... And enter the fan art, please. Feature it in a video if possible. Well, of course. I mean, this is what this thing's all about. Mr. P and the P is a knife. I like that little logo, okay? See how the P is a knife? I like that. That's kind of like an icon that I could use. Okay? I like it. That's neat. And I'll scroll up and down so you can see it. I like that. Because, like, you know how companies have funny logos and stuff like that? I wonder if I could do a Mr. Paladin with, like, spy stuff. But I like the idea you had with the knife. That knife idea was great. I liked it. See, look, I'm barely making a dent on these letters, man. You guys really like getting behind this mailbag stuff. I have to check my mailbox more often now. I'm probably going to have to, like, check it once a week. I mean, I got these packages I had to sign for, and I've got to make sure it doesn't go bad and, like, they send stuff back to you because I don't come up and sign for it, you know? Okay, dear Mr. Paladin, I'm a big fan of your videos and I love playing Spy thanks to you. Cool. Your How I Spy Things videos are very helpful and help me manage the cloak and find good spots for trick stabs, even though I'm a beginner trick stabber. Yep, it takes time. I've had to miss so many stabs, and I've had to fail so many times to start getting it down. And even then, you know, I fail stabs every now and then. It happens. Don't worry about it. I need to ask you, sometimes I can play really bad as a spy in one game and then make the MVP board in others. So does that mean I'm an all-round bad spy? No, it happens. I have bad games. Everyone has bad games. I mean, you guys see YouTubers and you just see all good stuff all the time. That's because we don't upload all the bad stuff. I mean, nobody wants to see the bad stuff. I mean, yeah, I die. People who have been in the community games with me, they get kills on me every now and then. I mean, whatever. My statistics are kind of, you know, generally good. I mean, whatever. But bad stuff happens. I mean, sometimes you're caught out. Sometimes you go for a risky move and the enemy just sees you and there's nothing you can do about it. Sometimes you've got a few stabs and suddenly on the back of all their minds is spy, 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 spy all the time and there's nothing you can do. I mean, whatever. I also find it annoying when I play MVM because they always kick me because I go spy. Yeah, in MVM, it's against the meta. Okay, I've been doing a couple of MVM videos, and I'll do a couple more, but in each one, I'm usually with a group of friends who kind of know who I am anyway, and they're not going to kick me. But people in MVM, they've worked out the meta that is the strongest stuff, and unless you're doing the strongest stuff, it's because people don't want to waste time, okay? They don't want to fail and then find out if the spy was good or not. You understanding me? They want to be able to just do their thing, get the reward, get done. I don't find that very fun, and that's why I don't play a lot of MVM. But I've done a couple MVM videos now, and I'm trying to say, you know what, Spy has its place if you get really aggressive and you really nut out the enemy AI. Well, I'd just like to tell you, keep up the helpful videos, and thanks for teaching me Spy. Yours faithfully. Off to visit your mother. Ooh, naughty. Oh, and on the back he's done little artwork. Oh, I've got to actually watch it. You've got your name and your address on the back, so let me fold that out. Done little artwork of my icon. I've recently had my icon changed. Did you see that? There was a fan on Twitter who updated my icon to have the new... Well, it doesn't have the new. It has my look with the Professor Specs, the Gnaw, and the Lady Killer. So I was very thankful for that. That's really good. About halfway there now. Ooh, this has got something in it. It's got something round in it. What in the world? Somebody sent me a cookie in the mail. Did I get a cookie? Again, I gotta watch that I don't slice myself. Again, I gotta watch that I don't slice myself. And I don't slice my cookie. If I got a cookie, it's gonna be delicious. Oh no, okay, they've made me something here. Okay, what have I got? Okay, I've got a little letter. I've got to look at the letter first. Oh, okay. I get it. It's Cody from the last video, and I'm sorry of all the typos. So I have a picture of your emblem. Check this out, okay? It's got these, you know, these things you can get from the arts and crafts or sometimes from the store, and it's got Mr. P on it. Isn't that cool? I'm gonna have to find a way to get it up on my board because I got magnets and stuff, but this is kind of a thick plastic, so that's cool. I like that a lot. That's neat as heck. Thanks for that, Cody. That's awesome. Let's see. I realize I haven't been saying the suburbs these ones been from. Like in a math sum. Like, it came through Charleston, so it's from that direction. Very careful as I open the letters, because I don't want to like slice through the letters. I just want to slice the envelopes. Okay, got some arts. See, this one's typed out. Dear Mr. P, I'm not much of an artist or a writer, but I did have a few questions and kind of wanted to be in the video. Well, there you go, you're in the video. We got everyone in the video. First off, a friend of mine named, I don't want to include the name because I don't want their account to be slammed, wanted to make an in-depth video about trick stabs because he watched all of the previous videos and is still a little bit confused. And I know you don't play Engie, but in your opinion, what is your favorite loadout? And which wrench do you hate the most to play against? Okay, when I play Engie, I usually go in two different modes. I'm either like a gunslinger with a pistol and a Widowmaker. That's very aggressive. It has a little bit more health. If you run out of ammo, you've got the backup of the pistol, right? So it's pretty aggressive. It's lots of fun to play, lots of moving around. The other thing is I go defensive, so I'm maybe a Southern Hospitality with a Rescue Ranger, and the secondary is either a Wrangler, depending on the map, if it's a Wrangler or not. So, you know, I'll swap between the two. I'll even take the proper wrenches on offense because it's fun to have a level 3 moving up. That depends on my team, if my team's reliable enough for that. Because if you're alone fighting a spy, it's not even worth the time to take a level 3. You know, take the gunslinger, and who cares if stuff gets sapped. Whatever. Your teleporters were level 1 anyway. Your dispenser's level 1. You're dropping down a mini sentry. Don't care about the spies. If a spy comes around, just pew-pew them down. Oh, sorry, you asked, which wrench do you hate the most to play against? The Jag. Because it always crits. That thing always crits every time. The engineer just comes out of spawn. It's a crit. He's had a sentry up for a long time. It's a crit. It doesn't matter. He's leveling up the teleporter. He's ting, 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 ting. Oh, there's a spy. Crit. It's so annoying. Weapons, okay, this is my opinion. Weapons that have a statistic on them that say, you know, this is less power than normal, should never random crit. That includes the Lutron J as well. I think it's silly that the Lutron J crits for just a few points underneath what a regular gun would crit. Silly, silly, silly. And do I have any tips for you? Because you just recently began maining engineer. Well, I'm going to be doing some more engineer stuff. I'm doing more other class stuff now, okay? I've done a lot of spy videos. I'll still play spy every now and then, but I'm going to do videos about everything and just show the fun parts of the game. because the game is fun. It's fun to play all the classes, it's fun to play all the maps, it's all good, it's all hilarious. So, yeah, I'll get another NG video out soon. I recently unboxed an engineer wrench, so why don't I use it? Heck, I'll use it. Let's do it. Let's just play engineer. Besides that, look for NG mains like Uncle Dane, okay? My uncle... Where's my little engineer? I recommend that you go visit Uncle Dane's channel. You know, it just makes sense. Those guys have a lot of hours in those other classes. Like, Raja has a lot of hours in Demo Man, you know. Look, there's lots of other pyros and stuff that are better than those than I am in those classes because they've got more hours invested into them and they've run into more situations so they can better explain it. About the only thing I've got is I can understand game sense really good, okay? I can see the flow of the game and that kind of helps me out when I'm playing other classes, but I'm still not as good as other people in a lot of other classes. So yeah, definitely. Like I said in a previous letter, it's that learning curve, okay? Watch videos, look at the wiki, make sure you know what the weapons are, make sure you know what your enemies use them, that kind of stuff. I'd also like to say your videos have helped me a lot when playing Spy and countering Spies. Definitely. And the art is on the back. Ha! Ah, look, I'm sapping a sentry. And you've got blood on my suit, so I can only assume there's a dead engineer around there somewhere. So I've got that for my board. And on to the next letter. Let's see, this one. This one's from Australia. But it's also got a Russian stamp on it. What? Where in the world? Okay, no, someone was confused. Someone put Australia on it, but put my Georgia address. I'm glad this letter got here. Someone, I think this is from, it's got Euros and it's got a Sochi stamp on it. It doesn't say who it's from, but they've put Australia down as part of the address, and that's not true, okay? Be very careful. I do not want my letters going to the other side of the world, okay? I'm from Australia, but I live in the USA, okay? Okay, this has got some art and some letter. Okay, dear Mr. Paladin, I've been subscribed to your channel for a few months now, and I absolutely love it. 90% of the time, the comments are nice, helpful, and friendly. I will say this, guys. I do filter out some comments because they're just not needed, okay? I don't like trolls in games, and I don't like trolls in my comment section. In your videos, you rarely swear, which I appreciate. Yeah, I do drop a cuss word every now and then. It happens. You know, your passions get going. As a spy main myself, your videos have also helped me to become a better spy. Keep up the amazing work. And they've got a smiley face there, but they've got this artwork, and it's in color. Got, hold on, we've actually got, there's some words. Okay, I've headshot the scout, I've backstabbed the NG, I've sapped the sentry gun. Then it says, Scout left the server on a rage quit, and NG left the server on a rage quit. Okay, I'm making people mad. Let me take it out a bit there. I'm making people mad with my loadouts, and it looks like I've got my Dead Ringer and Black Rose from the intro by the looks of it. Love it. That's neat. I like it. Ooh, okay, now we're starting to get into some of the package type ones, and I'm really excited about this last one, okay? This last one is big, and it's exciting. Let's see, this one's from... I don't know where it's from, it just has the 2 address on it. Just has the address it's going to. You've got to make sure to include your return address just in case they don't deliver it to me. You got to make sure it gets back to you, okay? Very important. Oh, it's got stuff. Oh, that's neat as heck. Oh, man. Check out this letter opener. I've got a little letter opener now. It's like It's like a claymore, which is cool because like my wife's family is like Scottish in heritage. So yeah, having a claymore is cool. I wish I could sharpen this up, but it can definitely be used as a letter opener. Let's see, what else do we have here? Oh, they've actually had a seal put on it. They put a seal on their letter. I'm breaking the seal. This is like official as heck. I think, oh mercy, it's like a wax seal. That's neat. I was like, I broke something because I saw the chips of the seal coming off, and I'm like, no. So wait, you put a letter inside a letter. You put an envelope inside an envelope. That's Inception right there. Oh man, this is interesting. Okay. Good day, Mr. Paladin. I cannot tell you how much I love your videos that you post. They not only provide good information, but they also entertain, amuse, and are always a pleasure to watch. I'm good. I mean, I'm good. No, I'm glad. I'm glad that you enjoy the videos because that's kind of the objective. It's kind of the point of it. I do try and watch myself. I do try and watch what I give you guys because I want it to be entertaining. I mean, if it's not entertaining, you're better off going to do your homework or something, and nobody wants you to do your homework. Let's see. I heard that you wanted a letter opener. Yes, I did. I got this as a letter opener, and I'm starting a little knife collection. But an official proper letter opener is cool. I love this. This is neat. I have one that is enclosed inside the envelope. Yep. I truly hope that it comes in handy with your future endeavors. Another thing I wanted to say, and thanks to all you do for the community. I and so many others appreciate your tutorials and demonstration videos, and I hope you have a great day and a long life. You're the first one to wish me a long life. I love it. And he's got his Steam ID there. Definitely. I don't give out the Steam IDs. Ooh, excuse me. I don't give out the Steam IDs to people just because I don't want you guys to get slammed. I mean, I get slammed by friend requests daily. I mean, my friend in my frequently asked questions, I've got my friends list as really, really full. So I can't really add anyone. And I've got to set this down there gently. So yeah, definitely I like the letter opener. I was thinking of getting an official letter opener before I started using the knife. And I actually did see something that was very much like this. It had a little sheath on it as well. But I mean, here, let me take this close. Can you see the detail? I got to get it into focus. You see it? It's even got some engravings on the little shaft of the sword there. That's cool. I like it. This one I know is from Australia. Okay. Because it's got Australia Post. Okay. The official symbol of Australia Post. And let's open this one up with my new letter opener. How about that? See, it functions exactly as a letter opener should. And this is from Narrabundah. Oh, wow, I haven't heard a suburb name like that in a while. Narrabundah. You see, you got a lot of Australian suburb names that are Aboriginal in heritage. So I'll have to look up what Narrabundah actually means. Wow, someone's got really nice handwriting. You've got your address on the back, which is great, which is what I just said in the previous letter. But now I get to use my letter opener twice. Twice on one letter, I get to open. What have we got? It's thick, it's like a card or something. Okay. Oh, wow, someone really does have nice handwriting. That is cool. I'll show you guys this in a, actually. Let me show you the picture first, okay? The picture's on a hard card, okay? But look at that handwriting. Let me zoom it in. Isn't that cool? That is really good artwork, and it's on a nice card too. And then the shading is all cross-hatched, like I was taught in school. I like that. That is very, very cool. Okay, g'day, Mr. Paladin. And again, the handwriting is really nice here. It's all blocked out like it was in the picture. Actually, and I'll show you this as well. Let me make sure I'm not showing your name because I don't want people to get slammed. See, it's got the Team Fortress 2 symbol, but look how that's blocked out. Someone's taken time to write this. It flatters me when I see stuff like this too. For starters, I wanted to say I love your videos. They've not only entertained me, but helped me better understand the game mechanics and strategies. I came pretty late into the party when it comes to first-person shooters. I played a little Unreal Tournament. Okay, that really helps me find out what time you got into the game when you tell me which game release you actually started in. As a teen, but I didn't really get into gaming until I discovered TF2. I'm an RPG tabletop nerd at heart. Cool, no problem there. I like me, like I said in the previous letters, I like me some RPG games like nobody's business. Your TF2 videos have been a source of inspiration and a fantastic learning opportunities for me. Not only in terms of personal gameplay, but in teamwork. It's also really refreshing to have a fellow Aussie in my YouTube subscriptions. I'm really glad. Oh, my tongue getting tired. I came across your channel when I did, and I look forward to your future work. Cheers. P.S. I'm bad at writing letters, but I drew your picture to make up for it. Are you kidding me? This letter was great. Then try not to underestimate yourself, guys. I mean, you guys are amazing me with this response, with the amount of letters and the amount of effort put into each of these. I know it's not common today to stop and sit aside and actually write, okay? It's becoming less and less. I myself have terrible handwriting, and I was glad when computers came along, so I was able to, clickety-click and select or change a font, and then everything looks pretty, okay? Writing to me was terrible. I said it before in a previous vlog. I held pens all kinds of incorrectly, so seeing people take time and effort, I appreciate it greatly. I understand that you guys take time out of your day to think about my channel, to think about me, to think about what I'm doing, and it's blowing me away. It really is. Now, this next letter is absolutely blowing me away, okay? I'm pretty sure I know who this is from, okay? First of all, I get this package and check out this, okay? It's got all sorts of Japanese writing on it, and there's not too many people I know worldwide. But I had somebody telling me to look out for this letter. And I'm pretty sure this one's from Who Howard. And on it, he has that it's listed as art, okay? He's actually listed it as art. So I'm getting an artwork here. So I'm trying to be very, very gentle with it to make sure I don't bust it up. Let's see, I'm gonna need my letter opener to get across the top here. No, this is too thick. I'm gonna need the big letter opener. It needs some serious cutting. The other letter opener is made to be gentle on letters, but I need to like rip into this one just at the top because I don't want to carve the art underneath, okay? I don't want to harm this package. Okay, what have we got here? Yeah, it's definitely from who? Yep, do not bend. Yep, I gathered that. Look, it's sealed with little animals. With cats, but I'm allergic to cats, too. I'm allergic to cats. Let's see, how do I get into this? You've tasted so well. Can I get into this? Yeah, I can. Okay, I can get into the corner here, in between the tape. Gonna watch that I don't cut myself. Yeah, who has let's see, I found out about who from Twitter actually. I saw something done and it was like an anime Team Fortress 2 thing. So I tracked him down and I said, you know, this is really, really cool stuff. And he's done a few thumbnails for me now. Oh, it's inside bubble wrap. I've got to be real careful with this. Oh, this is cool as heck. Oh, let me just open it up so you can start to see it. And on the back, okay, it's got all this. It's a note here. It says, "I drew this for you with my appreciation. I hope you like it. This is a watercolor painting, but coated by pastel, so be careful not to touch the colored part, okay, of your hand. It'll get dirty." Will the picture get dirty or will my hand get dirty? From your fan, Who Howard. Let me read that again to make sure. It's coated by pastel, so be careful not to touch colored part of your hand. Will get dirty. Okay. I think my hand will get dirty. So I've got to be careful of this. Man, who? I've probably got to frame this. Are you kidding me? This is off the chain. Okay, it's covered with this special tissue paper. Check out this. This is the shiznit right here. Look at that. That is off the chain. And who's got it signed on the back with a little thank you? Okay. That is cool. I'm gonna have to get this framed. I'm gonna have to get this frame to hang on my wall. There's no way I can put it up on my board over there. That is insane. Are you kidding me? Who is great at the art, man? I'm so glad I met up with him on Twitter. I've only met him on Twitter. I haven't met Who in person. Okay. Maybe someday I'd like to travel over there. I haven't gone to the Orient yet. I've gone to a lot of places, and I might show some pictures of some of the places I've gone to while I'm talking. And yeah, I like to travel, but travel is really expensive. But I would love to travel all over and take the wife all different places. It would be great. I mean, I greatly enjoy it. I'd love to meet the fans worldwide, and it blows me away, okay? Because you think about it, I got into computers and into gaming before the internet was thought of, okay? So it still does blow my mind when I do a video and it gets views worldwide and I get people internationally, you know, people from Greece, people from Canada, people from down in Brazil. I get people from all over, okay? It blows me away that people could be fans and just want to interact, just want to talk, okay? When I was in school, okay, we had a pen pal, and there was a pen pal I had in Germany, and I thought that was pretty great in itself, that I was able to send a letter back and forth to Germany. But now I'm getting artwork from someone on the other side of the planet. I met my wife, who is from America, while I was in Australia. It floors me all the time. Yeah, I'm gonna have to take care of these artworks, and I'm gonna be getting some more stuff, okay? I'm guessing I'm gonna have to frame this up and put it up on my wall, because it is amazing, Who. Thanks for watching. I hope my videos help you in your future endeavors. I love talking to you guys. I'm sorry I can't comment as often as I used to, because there's just so many comments. I try to comment, but, you know, as time allows, it becomes really, really tough. So, you know, don't feel bad if I happen to miss something that you really wanted me to see. I probably did see it, but I don't have the time like I used to have to respond to everything. Love yous all. Hope to see you next mailbag. The next one might be the digital stuff that I have on the discussion page of the Steam group. So, thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.